Pam Kelly says that she was motivated to pursue a career in broadcasting by three things. A love of rock and roll radio, admiration for the great jocks in Houston during the 1980s, and the desire to avoid getting a real job for as long as possible. Pam's radio career began in Bay City at KIOX. Pam quickly made the jump to Houston at KLOL, the station she grew up with. Working overnights, she assumed the identity of the Pampire, quickly forging a strong bond with the city's third shifters. From there, Pam pivoted to traffic, providing reports to KTRH, KIK, KILT, and KQ. After a stint doing overnights at KKRW, The Arrow, she landed at KTBZ, The Buzz, where she created The Texas Buzz, a show spotlighting up-and-coming bands. After a stint at KIOL, Rock 97.5, Pam did afternoons at KHBT, The Point, before landing at Contemporary Christian KSBJ, where she served as assistant program director and later did news during Morning Drive. For the past 5 years, Pam has worked at RFC Media, contributing to their formats, The Revolution, The Brand, and Third Rock Radio, NASA's official radio station. A spirit that enriches our industry and the passion that drives it. Please welcome Pam Kelly to the 2022 Texas Radio Hall of Fame.
I love too. I'm going to pull this down so you can hear how fast my heart is beating right now. I am so full of love and gratitude and so proud to be a part of this Hall of Fame. Congratulations to all my fellow inductees. You're all amazing. I'm so proud to be a part of this class. And well, I have so many actual humans to thank, but first and foremost, I have to thank God and rock and roll, and in that order. God, because I know every opportunity I've been given, any natural ability I've been given, and every person who's come in my path to encourage, inspire, and help me, and sometimes all three, and there's a lot of them in this room, they're directly from him, and for that I'm truly grateful. And I have to thank rock and roll, because that's what started this for me, the love of the music. My brother got me to listen to Houston rock radio, and look what just started. I couldn't make music, but I knew if I could be around it all day, that'd be a pretty sweet life, and it certainly has been. Thank you to all the voting members. I have to thank my mom and dad. My mom, the sweetest human in the world, my biggest supporter, always my biggest cheerleader, no matter what I did or tried. And my dad, who tried very hard to instill practical choices in me, and I wasn't listening, obviously. But I did hear him when he said, if you do something you love for a living, then you'll never work a day in your life. And he was absolutely right about that. And when I put him to the test and I said, Dad, I don't want to go back next semester and study advertising. I want to study broadcasting and be a DJ on the radio. He didn't laugh me out of the room. He actually heard me out. He supported me. He walked the walk. And he and my mom supported me all the way. And if they hadn't done that, I would not be standing here today. I get the emotional part now. My first inspiration to be a broadcaster was my cousin Sylvia. She was a news reporter and anchor for KPRC-TV. And on air, she was the picture of poise and professionalism. And off air, she was larger than life. And she encouraged me, she inspired me, she showed up for me. And I know I'm not the only one that she inspired, because there's her sister, my cousin Cindy, who, if you're from Houston, you may recognize as Cynthia Cisneros, 13, Eyewitness News. How'd I do? She inspired me. She encouraged me. She showed up for me. She took me to work with her, and she showed me a day in the life of a broadcaster. And at the end of that day, I said, Cousin, I really want to be a DJ on the radio. But I heard my dad, maybe I should choose a more practical career path. And she said, Pam. And everything stopped. It was like the needle scratched across the record. She said, you're a smart girl, and you're a hard worker, and you can do anything you put your mind to, and don't you ever forget it. And at that moment, a switch flipped for me, and I never looked back. So, Prima, thank you. I would not be standing here without you today. I owe a huge debt of gratitude to Steve Robison. He first hired me at The Buzz. He threw me into a million things I'd never done before. He was like, no, Pam, you have it. You got this. You can do it. He promoted me. He had my back down the line. He brought me into RFC Media in 2017, and I just could never thank him enough for all he's done. And Pat and Cruz, who isn't here, thank you for letting me play in the RFC sandbox. You guys are the most talented, creative innovators in the industry, and I'm so grateful to be a part of it. I truly am. Doug Harris, I haven't forgotten that you were the one who gave me my full-time gig at KLOL when you were interim PD. It was you. And I can't... Yeah, maybe. I can't thank you enough because it was truly the time of my life. I have so many KLOL stories, which I will not tell because my son is watching the live stream and my mom is here. And I'm not sure that the statute of limitations has expired. So I will just tell you that being in your 20s and working at KLOL was a really, really, really good time. And I will never, ever forget it. On the other end of the dial and on the other end of the spectrum of my radio career was KSBJ. And it's Christian radio in Houston. And I needed a gig. There was an opening. I mentioned it to my sister-in-law, Teresa, and I said, but I'm not going to apply. She said, no, Pam, you have to. I said, Teresa, have we met? I am an accomplished sinner. And I have unshakable faith, but I don't know how to talk about it on the air. I know country. I know rock. She said, Pam, you belong there. I feel it. Thank you, Teresa. She prayed. I applied. I walked in, and my life was changed forever. In short, my experience at KSBJ at the same time elevated my faith and took it deeper. And that's something that will bless me and those I love the most every day for the rest of my life. So thank you, Susan O'Donnell and Ty McFarland, for believing this rock chick had something to contribute to Christian radio. It's meant so much to me. Finally, you saw the bumper sticker frame on my bedroom wall as a teenager. I had the book covers, I had the bumper stickers, I had the 101 KLOL shoelace, and I still have one. And to go, that was my greatest dream when I was a teenager, to be on the radio. And to go from that, from here, to standing here, that's beyond my wildest dream, and I am so very grateful. Thank you all. God bless you all. Rock on. And go Stros, win it in six. Thank you.